My name's Tim Delaney. My story is I went out swimming last summer about the end of May. News and everybody else said it was okay. And of course, we thought it was okay since they were broadcasting on the local television to go on to the beach. Everything's gonna be all right and everything. We took our little four-year-old son. It's actually a three-year-old son. He was a three-year-old at the time. And basically he has a rare blood disorder, and his blood doesn't clot. And whenever we took him out to the water, his blood disorder basically went from an average case to a major thing where he basically had to get infusions three times a week. He'd only get blood infusions so maybe three times a year. And now it's three times a week after he went swimming in the Gulf.
Oh man.
And everything, yeah. And the we went to the doctors about it, talked to our doctors and everything, and they didn't want to hear anything about it, you know. And just everybody wants to just keep it hush hush, and you know, but you know, we gotta look at our problems and fix things, you know.
Yeah.
It's the only way it's gonna work out.
You're having mothers that are having spontaneous miscarriages because the corrective blows up the red blood cells. It's happening in Louisiana, up in New Orleans, and then I've heard in Mississippi, and then there were a few people in this area that had young women spontaneous miscarriages. We have photos of shrimps with no eyes. That's mutagenicity. Okay, yeah, we can. We'll send you anything you need.
You don't have over the back, and then this one is the same way.
People back to work.
You know, these down in there.
Safer. But
these things, they itch, and then they'll break open and bleed. And it's an endless cycle. That's what they do. And I've had them since October of 2010. And I'm detoxing, but they don't go away.
So what's your interest?
This is what we did.
This is what we did.
Trisha James went to the EPA and the FDA website.
Trisha James went to the EPA and FDA website.
They baffled you with bullshit.
They baffled you with bullshit.
They blinded you with science.
They blinded you with science.
They blinded you with science.
You can have one shrimp.
You can have one shrimp.
You can have 12 grams.
12 grams.
Of oysters.
Of oysters.
That is 3/4 of an oyster.
That is 3/4 of an oyster.
In one day.
In one day.
Over 5 years.
Over 5 years.
In order not to get cancer.
In order not to get cancer.
You can have.
You can have
49 grams.
49 grams
of finfish.
Of finfish.
That's fish with fins.
That's fish with fins.
In one day.
In one day.
For an 80-kilogram.
For an 80-kilogram
human being.
Human being.
Over 5 years.
Over 5 years.
In order not. To get cancer.
In order not to get cancer.
That includes.
That includes.
Lymphoma.
Lymphoma.
Leukemia.
Leukemia.
Bloodborne cancers.
Bloodborne cancers.
That includes bone marrow cancer.
That includes bone marrow cancer.
Woo!
Good job!
Could you do that one more time?
562 dead dolphins since the BP oil catastrophe.
562 dead dolphins since the BP oil catastrophe.
Yeah, make it shorter.
I don't have to start over. An oil spill was what happened in the Exxon Valdez.
It was an oil disaster.
This was a disaster, oh, wow. Y'all.
This was a
disaster, y'all.
Experts say as many as 50 times more dolphin deaths.
For everyone that is found.
Four dead dolphins in Alabama last week. One of which was a pregnant mother. Two of which was a mother and her calf. One death a month is normal. Now one or more a week with no signs of slowing down. Dolphin deaths are 10 times the normal amount yearly. Dolphin health equals humans' health. And other than that, it's my little saying.
There's 10 boats working with NOAA. And they're out there finding oil every day. They caught over 150 sharks and cut them open. They got oil inside of them. So we gotta save the sharks. We gotta save the dolphins. And we gotta save us. And we gotta save the Gulf.
Michelle Walker Harmon and Kimberly McHouston
are from Gulf Shores, Alabama.
And they love you. And they fought hard to be here today. And they want to tell the truth. Because they love you. Because they're protecting you.
They want your children to grow up happy and healthy.
They want your water to be clean. Because they love you.
We came here today.
From all the states on the Gulf Coast. Because we love you.
Because we want to protect you.
Because we want to protect your children.
Because we want to protect your children.
And we don't care if you think we're silly.
And we don't care if you think we're lying.
And we don't care if you think we're lying. Because if you think the government's telling you the truth.
Because if you think the government's telling you the truth.
Ask the people affected by Agent Orange.
Ask the 9/11 first responders.
Ask the people of Michigan oil spill.
Ask the people of Yellowstone oil spill.
Ask the people of Exxon Valdez oil spill.
Ask the people of Exxon Valdez oil spill.
Because we love you.
Because we love you.
We stand here. Because the oil's still here.
And so are we.
And we will not go away.
And we will not go away.
Because we love you.
God bless the Gulf.
God bless the Gulf.
What can we learn? How full by the memory. And what kind of lesson take to the grave? Turnstile and exile. Land of hard labor. And they sold you to freedom, they treat you like slaves.
To play, man. You're playing a little lower so you can talk.
Grandpa, the chaplain, world's tallest cypress. They could not get by on a moss picker's wage. Tell me, what can we learn from my forefathers' misery? And I pray we ain't destined to make that mistake. For the old folks might roll in their grave. What I thought was life in the dark of the night. Why can't this be paradise? Say. Paradise, no.
I don't. I want
to be. Don't live.